coming to terms with the death of a sibling is no easy task, no matter what your age. And that became the stepping stone for this author and her latest work.
In a difficult journey to heal her own heart and mind, author Susan Casey brings the stories of others who've lost siblings to the pages of her new book. And she's here with us this morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
First of all, you lost your brother. We're coming up on the anniversary.
Yes.
Next week is the anniversary. And
yes.
He was very young, 43.
Mm-hmm.
And it was sudden.
Yes.
Does that all play a factor, too, in adding to the grief if there's no time to prepare and if it's just is really the last thing you expect?
Absolutely. I mean, first of all, my brother was over in Hong Kong, and you know, we all live in Maine.
Yeah.
So it was very fast, it was very tragic, and then my brother and I had to fly over to Hong Kong, and we were there for about 3 weeks. It was the most tragic thing that's ever happened in our family.
Yeah.
Well, is that what, I mean, started you on the path to this book? What happened with you and that relationship and that event that brought you to the next step of saying, I need to share something with other people?
You know, I was blogging about my grief. I'm a therapist, and so I wrote my whole thesis on writing through trauma and the therapeutic benefits of that. And so when my brother died, the only thing I could do was put pen to paper. And mm-hmm. So I started a blog, and I got a lot of people responded to what I was writing about. And then I write in the book, like one morning I woke up at 3 o'clock and just heard the book title, you know, Mining for Joy in the Deep River of Grief. And I just knew I had to write a book. And I did it, I really did it for my own preservation to get through that. And then just some really magical, miraculous things happened with all the people that I ended up interviewing and how they came to me and their stories that I still hold so near and dear
to
my heart.
Is there a common denominator of the people that wrote you and talked to you that were in a similar situation that you were? I mean, you just mentioned how many and it touched your heart. Is there something that everybody had in common, in your opinion?
Sibling grief is not talked about enough.
Mm-hmm.
Siblings get lost in the grief because mm-hmm. if the sibling who has died is old enough to have a spouse and children,
right.
Everybody is concerned about them and
right.
the parents who lost a child. And so siblings just, they have to swallow their grief. They have to be strong for everyone. And it's incredibly excruciating, and I think it's very lonely. And all of the siblings that I interviewed, that was a very common theme that I actually write about too.
Well, and looking a little further into the topic, when I heard about your book,
mm-hmm.
I didn't see a whole lot out there that
there
addresses it.
There is not a whole lot
it.
Out there.
Even in a young child situation,
mm-hmm.
the parents would be so devastated at losing a teenager or a young child
yes.
that they would not be able to help the child who's the sibling.
Mm-hmm.
Does that make sense? So no matter the age, it would be a kind of an ignored sort of pain, not intentionally, but
right, because the parents are so bereft.
Right, right.
And as a matter
and
of
rightfully
fact,
so.
Right. In fact, there was an article that was just written after Kobe Bryant died around now these siblings are going to have to deal with sibling grief and loss. But I think I read a few books on parents who had lost a child when I was writing this book just to get an idea of where, you know, of what that was like for parents to be in that state of grief and also try to be a parent to their children. And it's very challenging. And
I wonder too if you also find that those left behind, like you and your other siblings sort of do the should to themselves, like I shouldn't be so sad because I do have my own life. I do have my own family. I have to be there for my parents, all of that, and that's never healthy. Did you find that?
I never did the should game. I just remember feeling like when is it my turn to be able to grieve? Because when we went over to Hong Kong, we had to be really strong for my sister-in-law and my little 3.5-year-old niece.
Yeah, and plus a lot of details to clean up.
A lot of details, yeah, which is another common theme, I think, for older siblings, that we take care of a lot of those details. You know, we took care of my brother. I wrote the obituary. I wrote his, his tribute for his, we also planned his whole memorial.
So you don't address your grief and your feeling. Well, the book will help, because yeah, there's nothing better than hearing from other people in the same situation.
Yeah. Thank you so much
for being with us. Thank you so much. Thank you for having me.